Now, my parents told me you're freaky. They never said I'm special.
About the common person and the special person. I know some teachers have always told us, and why your parents always tell you that, you know, you are special. Each one of us is unique and each one of us is special.
Now, my parents told me you're freaky. They never said I'm special.
And I remember this part. I'm not sure whether I heard it at your discourse or on a DVD of yours where you said, it was about, you know, people being special and us always thinking that God knows of us. And you said something like, do you know all the grasshoppers in your garden? So, of course, all of us have said no. So you said something like, so how does God know each one of you then? And I was devastated because I always thought somebody up there knows me, cares about me, and I'm special.
You thought you were number one on his book, is it?
Well, I've been told since I was a kid, you're unique, and God cares about you.
If when somebody says you're unique, it's an insult. It's like this. In this vast cosmos, this solar system is just a speck. Tomorrow morning, if the whole solar system disappears, vanishes, evaporates, nobody will even notice it. Maybe it's not even on the account books of creation. It's so small. In this speck of a solar system, planet Earth is a super speck. In that, Mumbai is a micro super speck. In that, you are a big man or a woman. This is a huge problem. This is a very immense existential problem. This is because we have lost perspective as to who we are, what we are. Our psychological realities have become bigger than the cosmic reality. That is a big problem. Today, everything in the cosmos is happening perfectly well, but you have one nasty thought crawling in your head and it feels like a bad day, isn't it?
Yes.
So that's because your psychological realities, your petty creation has become larger than the Creator's creation. You lost perspective of life. That is the fundamental basis of all this confusion and suffering. If you see who you are, the micro speck that you are, you wouldn't imagine that God is made in your own image and He looks like you and whatever. Okay, if we were all buffaloes, we would definitely think God is a big buffalo.